الحمد لله الحمد لله رب المشارق والمغارب خلق الإنسان من طين لازب ثم جعله نطفة بين الصلب والترائب خلق منه زوجه وجعل منها الأبناء والأقارب تلطف به فنوع له المطاعم والمشارب نحمده تبارك وتعالى حمد الطامع في المزيد والطالب وندعوه دعاء المستغفر الوجل التائب أن يحفظنا من كل شر حاضر أو غائب وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في أرضه وسمائه ملكه فحكمه فعدل فلحكمة لم يفعل ولحكمة فعل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الذي إذا قال فعل اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الأتقياء البررة وعلى من هذا هذوه وسلك سبيله إلى يوم الدين وبعد أيها الأحبة في الله My dear brother, my dear sister Give thanks to المجيد The all glorious Give thanks to Al-Majid, the glory, and the majestic. Give thanks to Al-Majidu, the one whose glory, the one whose generosity deserves all praise and honor. Al-Majid. He gave you everything. And he is giving you everything. And he will continue to give you because he is Al-Majid. He created the heaven and earth to serve you. He sent down the rain to serve you. With the rain, he provided you with what to eat and drink. He subjected the ship to sail through the sea by his permission to serve you. He subjected for you the rivers. He subjected for you the sun and the moon. He subjected for you the night and the day. And he gave you. And he is giving you. And he will continue giving you if you count. Try to count the mercy of Allah upon you. They are countless. You can never do so.
الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْفُلْكَ لِتَجْرِيَ فِي الْبَحْرِ بِأَمْرِهِ وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارَ وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ دَائِبَيْنِ وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ وَآتَاكُمْ وآتاكم من كل ما سألتموه وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها.
His mercy, his favors upon you are countless. So give thanks to him, worship him alone, because he deserves it. He is Allah, the one and the only, the majestic and the most high. I bear witness. And I bear witness our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his last and final messenger. My dear brother, take a gift from Rasulullah. One of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by the name Nawfal said to him, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, علمني شيئا إذا علمني شيئا أقوله إذا أويت إلى فراشي. O Messenger of Allah, teach me something that I may say when I go to bed. And now take the gift from Rasulullah. The Messenger of Allah said to him, اقرأ قل يا أيها الكافرون. Recite قل يا أيها الكافرون when you're going to bed. فإنها براءة من الشرك. It is freedom from polytheism. It is freedom from shirk. So from now onwards, take this gift from Rasulullah. When you're on your bed, before you sleep, recite قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. It is a gift from Rasulullah. I bear witness, he is the last and the final messenger of Allah. My brother, my dear sister, please, I want you to lend me your ears and your mind, because what I'm going to talk about today is serious. I want you to lend me your ears and your minds and all your attention, because what I'm about to talk about today is serious. What I'm about to talk, what I'm going to talk about today is something that diminishes all goodness in humanity. What I'm going to talk about today is something that leads to poverty. What I'm going to talk about today is something, is the cause of many diseases today that we are suffering from. My topic today is one of the major sins. Today, my reminder, short reminder to the whole, to my brothers and sisters, is a zina. What is zina? وطئ المرأة من غير عقد شرعي. Having sexual intercourse with a woman without religious approval. Having sexual intercourse with a woman without religious permits. Having sexual intercourse with a woman without marriage. This is my topic. And I know you believe that it is the cause of many problems today in this world. So I want to remind myself and my lovely brothers and sisters in faith that this disease is dangerous. It comes with many dangers, because the adulterer lies. He's a liar. Because the adulterer betrays. He's a betrayer. Because the adulterer never keeps his promises. The adulterer never keeps his promises. And the adulterer has no religious belief sometimes. Brothers and sisters, due to this, Allah, the Almighty, is reminding you and I in Surah Al-Furqan. Before we go there, He is reminding us first in Surah Al-Isra, ayah number 32.
ولا تقربوا الزنا
ولا تقربوا الزنا and do not go near adultery
ولا تقربوا الزنا
and do not go near fornication
ولا تقربوا الزنا
and do not come anywhere closer to fornication.
Are you following the word?
ولا تقربوا. Allah did not say ولا تزنوا. He did not say do not commit adultery, but no, ولا تقربوا. Do not go anywhere near to it.
Why? إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشًا.
Indeed, truly, absolutely,
إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشًا.
It is indecency.
إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشًا.
It is an outrage.
إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشًا.
It is shameful.
وَمَقْتَ.
An evil.
وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا.
And the opening to all evil doings.
الزِّنَا.
Very dangerous. So Allah is reminding you and I and commanding us to avoid zina, because it's the cause of many problems that the world is suffering from today. Brothers and sisters, a zina, fornication is everywhere today. In your hands you have it. In all your movements, except those who Allah protects. May Allah protect us. Zina is one of the major sins. It's one of the greatest sins in the sight of Allah.
Hadith of Bukhari. Hadith number 7520.
The Messenger of Allah was asked, Ayyu dhanbi a'zam indallah? Which sin is greater in the sight of Allah? The Messenger of Allah said, "An taj'ala lillahi niddan wa huwa khalaqak." An taj'ala lillahi niddan
wa huwa khalaqak.
You know, Allah is the one who created you. Now you have something that you take as God with Allah, to Allah, with Allah. How? أن تجعل لله ندا وهو خلقك. He is the one who created you. Number two. أن تقتل ولدك تخاف أن يطعم معك. To kill your child for the fear that he will eat with you. Three.
أن تزني بحليلة جارك.
To commit adultery with the wife of your neighbor. This is one of the greatest sins. سبحان الشاهد.
أن تزني بحليلة جارك.
Brothers and sisters, az-zina, adultery, fornication
is dangerous.
It is the main cause today of many diseases that the world is suffering from today. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whenever you see zina is all over, is out, without, you know, today, you see zina everywhere. People don't even hide it. It's all over. The Messenger of Allah said, wherever you see that, this is the hadith of Ibn Majah. Hadith number 4019. Whenever you see that, see that it's all over. It's opium.
Illa fasha fihi bitta'un.
The next thing you will see is diseases will attack people. Lam takun. Before, our ancestors don't even know about it. They never heard about it. Most of the diseases we are suffering from today, lam takun badat fi aslafihim, fi aslafihim, that our ancestors never heard of it. Our ancestors never heard of HIV. But today we are suffering from it. Why? Because of azina. Many diseases today. So my dear brothers and sisters, let's avoid zina. Let's stay away from zina because it is dangerous. Brother, today, sister, zina is open. Subhanallah. Sometimes I ask, where is the shame? We are today living in a society where married women today, some married women are fighting over a man. How? Where are we going to? What is wrong with us? Married women. Women that are married, some of them today, fighting over a man. And some brothers today are fighting over somebody's wife. Some of the brothers, you tell them today, they tell you, all I want is married woman. Are you serious? Somebody's wife. If they do that to your wife, will you be happy? If someone have sexual intercourse with your wife, will you be happy? Why do it to somebody's wife? That woman is someone's daughter. That woman is somebody's mother. She is somebody's auntie. Will you like it for yours? For your parents? For your mother? For your auntie? For your daughter and for your sister? Are we believers, true believers? Because the true believers of Allah will not do that. Didn't you hear the saying of Allah in Surah Al-Furqan? وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْلًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما. Now listen, who are the true servants of Allah among them? والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر. Ayah number 69, Surah Al-Furqan. لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر. They never commit shirk.
ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق.
And they don't kill innocent souls. Listen.
ولا يزنون.
And they don't commit adultery.
وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَٰلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا.
Whoever does that will face the penalty. Whoever does that, the fornicator, will face the penalty. What is the penalty, Ya Allah?
يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا.
His punishment will be multiple. His punishment will be doubled, and he will stay in the punishment forever.
Why?
How many minutes enjoyment is it that you're going to stay in hellfire forever? How many minutes did you enjoy? With all due respect, how many minutes is it? All this enjoyment, how many minutes is it? After a few minutes, you are gone. Then why selling your Jannah for this little enjoyment? So brothers, let's avoid fornication. And I go to you, those on social media, be careful. Those on social media spreading indecency, spreading dirty pictures, spreading pornography, sharing dirty pictures. People are watching because you sent it. People are watching because you shared it. Brother, keep sharing. You will share for the rest of your life if you don't stop. Do you know my proof? Have you ever seen where a person is dead, but at the same time he is sharing? Only in social media. You share those pictures, the password is with you, you are dead. Who can delete it? So go and delete it now. Go. Delete it now before the angel of death knock at your door. Because whenever he knocks, he will not go back. He will not give you time to remove it. So delete all that, so that when people go on your page while you are no more, the only thing they will see is remembrance of Allah, not pornography, not dirty pictures. Whatever you leave behind, the reward will go to you. Do you know it is not only, do you know the eye also commits zina? Do you know that? Yeah. The eye commits zina. The hands commits zina. So now, when people watch this pornography, it leads to zina while you are in your grave. Congratulations. Didn't you hear what Allah said? In Surah to Yasin, Inna nahnu nuhyi al-mawta wa naktubu ma qaddamu wa atharahu wa kulla shay'in ahsaynahu fi imamin mubin. Allah said, we revive the dead and we write what they have presented ahead. Wa atharahum, and what they left behind, and their footprints, and their prints, and their traces. Atharahum. So you left dirty picture on your page, you sent dirty pictures, your friends will see it after your death. This is how they will remember you. Oh, so and so sent it to me. Well, he's dead. Congratulations. This is what you want to leave behind you. So please delete it, because it leads to zina. All this is how zina spread. A Muslim not supposed to be sharing something dirty, because you are the follower of the ambassador of what? Of cleanliness, Muhammad Rasulullah. The ambassador of purity, Muhammad Rasulullah. The teacher of humanity, Muhammad Rasulullah. He did not teach you that. After that, I know you will delete it. Or maybe later you will delete it. Now, I come to you, Grandpa, who is committing zina. Old man. Today you see some old people. Old man committing zina. How? With all due respect, Grandpa, what remains now? Because of your money, your power, wealth, sugar daddy. What else remains for you? Would you just sit down and do some thinking because you are getting closer to your great grandpa? An old man committing zina? Do you know that there are some people that Allah will not speak to on the day of judgment? Listen to the messenger of Allah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, ثَلَاثَةٌ لَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. There are three groups of people that Allah will not speak to on the day of judgment. Number one, Shaykhul Zani. An old man who commits adultery. It doesn't fit you. It doesn't fit you. It doesn't even fit the young man. Talking about you, the grandpa. You have wives, you have children, you have grandchildren, and you admit you are committing adultery? What kind of satanic act is this? This kind of people are among those who Allah will never talk to speak to on the day of judgment. وَلَا يُكَلِّمُهُمْ وَلَا يُزَكِّيهُمْ and will not purify them. Another riwaya, وَلَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهِمْ he will not even look at them. Subhanallah. The day the believers will be enjoying looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The day of wujuhun yawma'idhin nazira ila rabbiha nazira. On that day Allah said he's not going to look at you. So brother, my sister, this is my short message today. Let's fear Allah and stop and avoid adultery. Stop sharing pornography. Stop sharing dirty pictures. Stop sharing dirty talks. Whatever you leave behind you that you know will affect you in your grave, stay away from it because it will not do you any good. Now, Imam, okay, I heard what you said. I committed zina. I did it a lot everywhere. Will I be forgiven? Will I be forgiven? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولك. بارك الله فيك. Now, brother, I committed zina. Will I be forgiven? I did it many times. Maybe he will say, even last night I did it. But now that I heard this, will I be forgiven? Brother, congratulations. Your Lord is Allah. I repeat, congratulations, because your Lord is Allah. Go back with me. Surah Al-Furqan. When Allah promised to punish those who are doing that act, listen, there is an exception. And I pray that you will be part of the exception. Say Ameen, brother. Yes, he committed adultery. He did it a lot, many places. But now that he heard the seriousness of it, he stopped. He repents. Except he who repents and believe. وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا and act righteously. Oh Allah, thank you, Ya Rabb. Thank you, Ya Rabb. Brother, our Lord is forgiven. Look at this. Except he who repents and believe and act righteously. Listen, Ya Allah, what are you going to give the person? You see, those يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات. اللهم لك الحمد يا رب. اللهم لك الحمد يا رب. فأولئك. You see, those يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات. He said he will change, he will replace your evil acts to good. Allah. Who can do this if it's not Allah? You did what you did. But he said, if you repent and you believe and you come back to him, all those sins, he said he will make it reward. Please say Alhamdulillah. All the sin you committed, he said, if you come back, if you repent, if you ask him to forgive you and believe, he said, he will forgive and he will change it to. He will change it to good. He will make it good. He will make it good. So, Bristol, please, if you have CVR, well, CRV, taxis T740136C, black, please, or Bristol, they want to move. Brother, if you come back with all the adultery, with all the sin, he said he will forgive you. فَمَنْ تَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ظُلْمِهِ وَأَصْلَحْ فَإِلَّا اللَّهَ يَتُوبُ عَلَيْهِ. Whoever repents after his evil doing, indeed, absolutely, Allah said, welcome, I will forgive you. May Allah forgive us our sin. Brothers, let's repent. Let's ask Allah to forgive us. It is dangerous. If it continues, we will suffer. May Allah forgive us our sin and increase our faith. Make us strong in Iman. Brother, I stand here. Our brother Bafoni lost his sister. She died yesterday in an accident. We pray, may Allah forgive her. May Allah grant her Jannah. We lost one of our auntie back home in Ghana. We pray, may Allah forgive her and grant her Jannah. We lost our mothers and fathers. We lost our loved ones, our brothers, our sisters, all Muslims all over the world, those who died, we pray, may Allah grant them Jannah. When it's time for you and I to die, I pray, may Allah make our final word, La ilaha illallah. May Allah make this easy for us. May Allah forgive us. May Allah increase our faith. May Allah increase our faith. Ya Allah, we are sick. Ya Allah, heal us. Ya Allah, we are sick. We pray that you heal us. Ya Allah, we have brothers in the hospital. You know, Ya Allah, we pray that you heal them and you protect us, Ya Allah. Those looking for job among us, may Allah give them good job. And those who have the job, may Allah protect them. Those with the businesses, I pray, may Allah continue to bless you. May Allah continue to bless your business. And our brothers, the taxi drivers, I pray, may Allah protect you. May Allah protect you. May Allah protect you. May Allah protect you. The way you leave your home with Bismillah, always you come home with Alhamdulillah. May Allah make this easy. May Allah bless our children. Allahumma hdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa barik lana fi ma a'tayt, wa qina sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma hdina wa hdibina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma ya qadiran ala kulli shay, اغفر لنا كل شيء اغفر لنا كل شيء اغفر لنا كل شيء إذا وقفنا بين يديك يا مولانا فلا تسألنا عن أي شيء برحمتك يا رب العالمين يا رب العالمين ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم تبنا إلى الله تبنا إلى الله تبنا إلى الله وندمنا على ما فعلنا من الذنوب اللهم اغفر لنا ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وقوموا إلى صلاتكم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
Please, let's straighten the line straight. Keep the line straight. Like I always say, we can ignore the lines on the carpet. Just make sure our lines are straight. Barakallahu fikum. It's still. And please, after the prayer, one of our brother, Allah bless him with a baby. He wants you please to stay just 5 minutes after the prayer to pray for the baby. May Allah bless the baby. It's still. Phone off. Inshallah. Oh.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هولا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. الله سمع الله لمن حمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما. والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما. يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. أستغفر الله، لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. أستغفر الله، أستغفر الله، أستغفر الله، أستغفر الله، لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. الله أكبر. لقد من الظالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
First, may Allah accept our prayers. Sisters, Allah accept our prayers. May Allah forgive us. May Allah make things easy for us. Inshallah, where is my brother? For the name, inshallah. Inshallah, where's my brother for the name, inshallah? Inshallah, barakallahu feekum. May Allah accept our prayers. Fi sabilillah. Jahidu bi amwalikum wa anfusikum fi sabilillah. May Allah make things easy for us. May Allah forgive us our sin. May Allah bless all of you. May Allah bless all of you. May Allah protect you. Fi sabilillah. Jahidu bi amwalikum wa anfusikum fi sabilillah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Okay. Alhamdulillah.